Welcome to today's lesson. So this is lesson 4. So we're still in insert menu, and I'll be tackling illustrations category. So in this category, we have the pictures, online pictures, shapes, smart art, charts, and the screenshot. So remember, this is all based on Office 2016. So if you have Office 207, you'll have different icons appearing. So this is what we'll be tackling today. So insert menu, illustrations category. So I'll move very fast, and I'll start with the first icon, and that is inserting a picture. So if you ask to insert a picture, let me simply generate random text so that we get to see how we insert this and what happens. So in the insert menu, simply click on pictures. But before you click on pictures, always remember that you have your cursor where you want your pictures to be inserted. So for instance, I'm going to insert the picture just after the first paragraph. So at the end of the first paragraph, I'll simply press enter to move the cursor to a new line, and then in the insert menu under illustrations category, you simply click on pictures. So after you do this, you're going to select any picture that you have. So simply choose one. So it doesn't matter the location. Simply, if it is in the desktop, move to the desktop, find the picture. If it is in your flash disk, move to this PC, choose the picture. If it is in the documents, do the same. If you had downloaded it, you'll find it in the downloads location. So you simply move to downloads, choose the picture. So in this case, I have the picture in the pictures location, so I simply click on it, then I click on insert. So we'll have the picture inserted. Now, when you have this picture inserted, if you try moving this picture, it doesn't move. Now, this is something we'll tackle, and I'll also talk about it. If you want to move your pictures freely, then I will be changing the text wrapping or the wrap text. So that is something we'll do. Now we'll start with some of the basic functions in MS Word when you're dealing with the picture. So if you're very keen, you'll note that this picture is active. If I click outside, then in the menu bar, we don't really have home, insert, design, layout, reference, mailings, review, and view. We don't have another menu, but if I simply click on this picture, then we have the format menu, which has picture tools selected. So this is now active. It will only appear when you've selected a picture or maybe an object. So that is something you need to know. Now with this, how do you resize a picture? So we have these points, the resizing points. So if you move your pointer to the top right of the picture, where you have this point, you'll note the pointer changes to diagonal resize 1. If you move your pointer in between, this is the horizontal resize, and you also have that here. We also have diagonal resize 2, and we also have that appearing here. And we have vertical resize 1. Vertical resize also appearing here. So if you want to resize a picture, always remember to use diagonal resize 1 or 2. So it can be at the top left, top right, bottom left, bottom right. Don't resize a picture using the horizontal resize or the vertical resize. This changes how your picture looks like. So we'll simply move our pointer to the diagonal resize 1. Then you simply click, as you remember, the pointer has to change from normal select or the text select to this pointer. Then you simply click as you hold, and then you drag towards the center. So this is reducing on the size. If you want to increase the size, you can also use that, or the one at the bottom right. Simply click as you hold and drag away from the center. So very important. Simply click as you hold and drag towards the center or you can also do that to increase the size. So you can increase the size and decrease the size using the diagonal resize one. And you know, this picture is proportional. It doesn't stretch anything. Everything is proportional when you use diagonal resize one. And that is something you need to learn how to use. You can also rotate the image if you want to. So note this is a normal select. Then we have the move tool, the vertical, sorry, the diagonal resize one pointer, and then we have a pointer that shows you that you are now able to rotate the image. So if you ask to rotate this image, you simply move your pointer to this point, click as you hold, and then drag. So you note it rotates, and you can change that to 180 degrees. You can also rotate it to 90 degrees, and you can do that. So you simply click as you hold and drag. Please note, when you're in the format menu, you can also do the resizing bit, and you can also rotate. So if you ask to rotate 90 degrees, simply click on in the format menu under arrange category, simply click on rotate, choose any option. So either we have rotate right 90, left, and as you move your pointer, you'll note what happens to the image. You can also resize. So we have size, simply increase the size. This is the height. Simply click, and remember it is proportional. So as you change the values in the height, it also changes the values in the width. So having done that, we also have the picture styles category. So in the picture styles category, we have some styles that we can apply. So you simply click on the R with the name more under format menu. And then as you move your pointer, you'll note it changes how, or it basically applies a different style from what you had earlier. So I'll choose this. And all these have names. We have thick matte black. We also have simple frame white. All that. So as you move your pointer, you'll note they have different names. So we also have bevel perspective and all that. So as you move your pointer, it gives you the name of the style. So I'll choose this, and it changes how my picture looks like. On the same, we also have picture border. So if you want to maybe apply a picture border, change the color, you use that. We have picture effects. So we have the preset if you want to apply reflection to the picture, if you want to apply glow, if you want to use bevel, if you want, you also have 3D rotation. So those are things that you can also apply. So I'll simply apply a shadow. So in the picture effects, choose shadow, then I'll choose under perspectives, I'll choose one, and there we go. Or I can also change that shadow and choose this one. We also have adjustments that you can apply to your picture. So if you want to remove the picture, you can remove the picture. We also have brightness correction. If you want to increase the brightness, if you want to decrease the brightness, and you note as you move your pointer, it changes the brightness of the content. You also have color, so you can recolor. You can choose a different color, maybe that or white or black. So we have recolor, and you can also set transparent color. So if you want to do it with the background, simply click on that. Your pointer changes, and you simply click on that, or the background, it's going to do away with that. Then we have artistic effects. So it changes how your picture looks like. So there we go. So like if I choose this, you know the difference from earlier on. You can also compress, you can change the picture, and you can also reset the picture. Now, if I want this picture to move, you have to change the text trapping. So in the format menu under arrange category, we have text trapping. Simply click on the drop down arrow. We have inline, square, tight, through, behind text, in front of text, all that. So if I choose tight, and I should be able to move this freely. You can also choose a different one, maybe through. So if I move the picture, it moves. So you note it moves. With at the left, the content moves. At the center, the content moves. So you can apply that. You also have picture position, where you want the picture to be placed. So we have with text wrapping. So we have position in top left with square text wrapping. You also have top center, top right, like that. So if you want it at the center, you simply choose the middle one. If you want it at the bottom, right, top, center, all that. So these are things that you can also apply. So that is it with the pictures. So remember, you can also try to apply all that. You also have reflection if you want to apply reflection. Then lastly, under the pictures, we'll talk about cropping. So if you want to crop, basically you want to move or remove any unwanted areas of the picture. So with this picture, maybe you want to do away with some sections. So you simply, in the format menu, remember, if you don't have the format menu, click on the image. So we have format menu, we have crop. Simply click on crop, then you can remove a section that you don't want. Maybe, let's say we want to do away with the icons for Excel, Word, PowerPoint, etc. So I'll simply select that, then I click outside. So we'll have the image only containing the icon and the name of the text office. So that is done. So we'll move to the second icon in the insert menu. We have online pictures, and this is the same. The only difference is you need internet for you to apply or maybe insert this picture. So you simply move to online pictures, then it's going to use your internet. Remember, you'll only use this option if you have internet. Search for the image, maybe let's say that. Then you press enter, it gives you the images, and you can choose one that you want to insert. Maybe that, you simply select and then you click on insert. So it's going to download the image, then it's going to insert the image. And you can also apply all these styles. You can apply a picture, maybe a reflection if you want. You can reduce the size of the image. You can also apply text wrapping so that you're able to move this picture freely in your document. Number three are the shapes. So I'll simply use a new page. So if you want to insert a shape in the insert menu under illustrations category, we have the shapes icon. Simply click on the drop down arrow, then you have all the shapes that you want. So you simply click on any shape that you want to insert. Then your pointer changes to a plus sign, the precision select. Click as you hold, drag, and it's going to insert the shape. And you can also edit or apply the shape styles. If you want to delete, simply click, press delete. In the insert menu, again, shapes, any other shape that you want to insert, click as you hold, drag. And there we go. And you can also apply styles. You can apply shape fill. You can apply shape outline. You can also apply shape effects. So that is how you insert an image. Sorry, an image. That is the pictures, the online pictures, and the shapes. So you simply click on the image, click as you hold and drag. Then I simply delete. Number four are the smart arts. So in the insert menu, simply click on smart art. Then we have all. You can also choose different categories. So depending on what you want to insert. So maybe I'll choose hierarchy. Then I'll choose one that I want to use. So maybe this, and then I click on OK. So we'll have the smart art inserted, and you simply click where you have text, and then you simply key in the content. So like I'll key in father, and the second one maybe mother. Third we have son. Fourth maybe daughter, and maybe last one. So this is hierarchy. So you can simply insert smart art by moving to insert menu, clicking on the smart art and choosing at category, and then you simply choose, then you click on OK. Number four, actually number five, we have charts. So how do you insert charts? So in insert menu, illustrations category, click on chart. So after you click on chart, it gives you insert chart category. Simply choose the chart type that you want. So we have column, line, pie, etc. So I'll choose column. We also have different styles here. So I'll choose the default one, click on OK. So after I do this, it moves it to Excel. So I'll only key in some content. So female, male, and other. Then I'm comparing this against 2017, 2018, 2019, and 2020. So let's say the female were 56, the other was 78, 90, and 67. And as I key in the content, you'll also note the chart. We have some changes being applied. So we have 5 there, 7, we have 12, maybe we have 15. Then I can simply close this. So we have, there we go. So you can insert a chart in MS Word. And if you want to format, we have the chart styles. Maybe if you want to apply that, simply click on it. If you want to change the colors, you can do that. If you also want to change chart type, simply choose that. Choose a different chart type, click on OK, it changes automatically. So you'll note we also have the legend here. So other, male, female, and all are compared in your document. Lastly, we have screenshot, inserting a screenshot. So I'll move to Google. Maybe I'll key in a computer. Then under images, then I'll screenshot this by pressing print screen. Then I'll move to paint. If I move to paint, I'll simply paste, then I can save this under pictures with the name Google. So in MS Word, with your cursor blinking, where you want to insert the screenshot is like just like picture. So screenshot, remember I pressed print screen. So when automatically when I click on the drop down arrow, I have contents here. So I simply click on the one from Google, and there we go. That's how we insert a screenshot. So I'll stop from there. Make sure to subscribe. Hit the subscribe button so that you get more when we upload.